Welcome again. We'll start with one of the major topics under Indian culture, and this topic comes under performing arts. So under performing arts, we'd be talking about circus, we'd be talking about puppets, the various musics and the various dances of India. So what today we would cover is an Indian circus. Now this topic has not been a part of the UPSC question paper since a long time. So however, this is important, and this is an art which is kind of vanishing in India with the present scenario. Now, how can we define a circus? Circus is a group of performers which includes magic shows, clown tricks, clown shows, various taming acts, training of animals, and the various artistic performance including acrobatic performance. Now, India has not got a good recognition for circus because of the financial constraints. Again, there are very few performers which are present in India nowadays. Initially, it all started back in 1880s, where we had, when it started, we had around 300 circuses, but as of present, there are only 23 circuses that are left in India. Now, Philip Estes says that the first circus was around 1880s that we started with, and that was a very new industry during that time. Now, we'll talk about the father of Indian circus. Now, father of Indian circus was Vishnupan Chatre, and he started the Great Indian Circus, which was the first Indian modern circus. He was an equestrian and a singer, and he was known for this as a stable master because he was under the Raja of Koduvadi. And the most interesting part of the story is when he went with this Raja into a circus of William Christine, that was an Italian circus that came to Bombay during that time. He was astonished by the remark given by Chirni, who said that Indians do not have the capability to perform and would have to wait for another decade to start circus if they want to in India. And this led Chatre to work around the circus, and he initiated the idea of circus and finally started the circus. So he was able to perform numerous stunts which were supported by horses, and the first performance was done in March 1880. His wife was also a trainer of wild animal and a trapeziary. So both of them, they started with a circus. Then they started and toured the North India, South India, Ceylon, Southeast Asia and United States. In America, as he went there, it became very difficult for him to struggle with one of the most world-famous circuses, which were known as Branham and Bailey Circus during that time. And this gave him a big blow and a competition, but however, he could not stand. Later on, you had Kerali Kunhi Kanan, who was considered as the father of Kerala circus. Now, Kerala is known as a place for origin of numerous circuses. In 1901, they opened the school of circus, which was known as Chirkara in Kolam. And in 1904, they started the company, which was known as Great Malabar Circus. Now, some of the other companies started by Kanan includes the Whiteway Circus, Great Ramayan Circus, the Lion Circus, Eastern Circus and Fairy Circus. Later on, Kerala was known as the cradle for Indian circuses, and many of his students started their own circus centers and their own circuses. In 2008, Government of India started a circus academy in Thalassery, in Kerala, in the memory of Kunhi Kanan. The next was Damu Dhotre. He was a world famous animal trainer, and he started a circus during 1930s, which was known as the Ringling Circus. He was also acknowledged during the court of Alfred, and he was known for handling even wild animals like leopard. In the 21st century, as we can see, there has been a great blow to the Indian circus with only 23 circuses left. Some of the performers, you have the various photographic performances that started in 2006 and 2015, there was a kind of theory that was developed to model the Indian circus, which was fighting its existence. Now, some of the major circuses are here. We'll be discussing these circuses one by one. So the first one that we'll be discussing is the Great Royal Circus. This is one of the oldest circus in India. It was started by Madhusekar in 1909. later on taken over by Valvakar and was known as the Great Royal Circus. So it started as the Great Indian Circus, and later on it was known as the Great Royal Circus. It went through Africa, Middle East and Southeast Asia. Then we'll talk about the Great Ramayan Circus and Amar Circus. It was founded in 1920 by Kalan Gopalan. It was built on the empire of National Circus and Bharat Circus together. Later on, he started the Amar Circus in 1960, and Amar Circus comes under the recent management of Hemraj and has been included in Limca Book of Records for the best outstanding acrobatic performances. The next is Great Bombay Circus. It started in 1920 by Babu Rao Kadam. It was previously known as Grand Bombay Circus and later on known as Great Bombay Circus. In 1947, Kanan, whom we already talked about, who was the founder of the Kerala Circus, merged his circus company with the Grand Bombay Circus Company, and together they became the Great Bombay Circus. It is also one of the largest circus company with nearly 300 performers and 60 animals, and they have recently performed in Sri Lanka and South Africa. The next is Three Ring Circus, started by Damodaran. Now it started as a two pole circus, later on became a six pole tent, which was first of its kind in Asia, and he became a popular ring master, what we have already talked about previously. And again he was presented with a shield by then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru for his outstanding contribution to entertainment industry. The next was Gemini Circus, started in 1951 in the town of Gujarat, which was known as Bilimora, under the leadership of Shankaran and Sahadevan. In 1964, it was the first circus to hold the international circus festival in USSR, and performed in Moscow, Sochi and Yalta. It has ties with the film industries in India. So many of the films that have scenes of circus include Gemini Circus. Some of the films are Raj Kapoor's Mera Naam Joker, Mithun Chakravarti Shikari, and Kamala Hassan's Apoorva Sahodangaral. Now the next is Raj Kamal Circus. It is started with Gopalan Muloli, and it is started in Zera in Punjab. This was named after his son Raj and his wife Kamala, so merged together known as Raj Kamal, and it has two till Gulf countries. The next is Jumbo Circus. This is also known as Pride of India and is the largest circus of modern time. It is started in the Dhanpura in Bihar state in 1977, later acquired by Shankaran family. So it's under the Indo-Soviet exchange program. So you have people from Soviet Union who are part of this entertainment group. This is the largest troupe entertainment in India and has been performing very nicely since last 20 years. The next is Rambo Circus, started by Dilip in 1991. It includes four circuses, that is the Oriental, Arena, Victoria and Fantasy, and is now run by Sujit and Sumit Dilip, who are the sons of the original founder. Now let's understand about this industry a bit. When we talk about circus as an industry, it had a kind of great blow in the starting, but slowly and gradually it is wiping off. Now let's understand the major causes for this. The first is, you have a kind of, this industry has been kept secret. It involves lot of animals. So with the banning of the use of animals, there has been a kind of blow to this industry since 1977's decision. Then it's again a dangerous profession, because towards the end you have the death of whale. So that's whale of death. So that's again a kind of challenging phenomena. Then you have to match the competition with other entertainment industries. So the cost becomes very high, carrying so many artists, so many animals together from one location to another has its inborn cost. And again, the acrobatics that is required the acrobats must undergo intensive training, so that again becomes difficult. Now what could be some of the remedies? First of the remedies could be providing certain safety regulations for them. giving them certain security and compensation benefits, government protection, bringing this circus industry under Ministry of Culture, which would be one of the foremost ideas. And as a result, you would have more protection and more promotion that would be given to this industry. And it's one of the dying arts of the Indian performing arts. So with this, we cover the topic on circus. We'll be covering the topics on puppetry and dance and music in the upcoming lectures. So stay tuned for more lectures on Indian culture. Now, these are definitely part of general studies paper. We have also started the general studies test series. So you can subscribe that at Doorstep Tutor. We would provide personal feedbacks for each and every paper that is being sent in. So you are more than welcome to look onto those papers. And even if you are not sending those, at least solve those questions, because those questions have been from the recent contemporary happenings, and those are definitely important for your upcoming examinations. So stay tuned. Have a good day.